Gettysburg traveled to Dickinson in a game for the Little Brown Bucket, and the Red Devils struck first on this Colonel 65-yard touchdown run. Gettysburg took a 10-7 lead on this short touchdown run by Nicky Lassen, and then extended his lead to 17-7 on this touchdown pass from Zach Miller to Fred Caruso. Trailing 23-10, Dickinson struck late in the second quarter on this touchdown pass from Manel to Devin Gabby to make it 23-17 at the half. And then Dickinson took the lead 24-23 as Cedric Madden piles into the end zone. Miller teams with tight end Fred Pulzello on this 38-yard touchdown pass to give Gettysburg a 29-24 lead. After a Dickinson field goal, the Red Devils had one more chance, but this pass was picked off by linebacker Chris Miller. Zach Miller does the rest. Dickinson balls to Gettysburg 36-27. Eighth-ranked Johns Hopkins traveled to Lancaster to take on Franklin and Marshall, and the game started with a bang. Bradley Monday took this short kickoff, found room on the far sideline, and rambled deep into Franklin and Marshall territory. From there, Brandon Cherry did the honors to give the Blue Jays a 7-0 lead moments into the first quarter. Braden Anderson looks deep, but he's picked off by Brandon Daly. And that'll set up Scott LaValvo on this short touchdown run to tie the game. Later in the third quarter, it was LaValvo again to give F&M a 14-10 lead in the third quarter. But Hopkins had the answer. Anderson on the post pattern to Monday, who pulls it in, keeps his balance, and has 59 yards for the touchdown. Moments later, Anderson calls his own number and runs 54 yards to pay dirt, making a 24-14 Hopkins lead. Stuart Walters, who had the capper, Johns Hopkins remains unbeaten 33-14. Muhlenberg struck quick against Ursinus. Here, Nick Lamb takes a short touchdown pass to make it 10-0. Corey Kelly makes it 10-7 on this short plunge, and then Nick Palladino to Mike Harris makes it 17-7 Mules. Kevin Monahan to Darius Jones makes it a 17-13 game before Palladino teams with tight end Michael Long to make it 24-13 at the break. Then Palladino on the post to Lamb, 36 yards to make it 31-13. Ursinus closes the gap on Monahan's second touchdown pass, but Max Cepeda wraps up for Muhlenberg 41-27. Moravian visits Juniata, and Ward Judinski gets the Eagles started early on this 6-yard touchdown run. Then Moravian punter Jimmy McCarthy calls his own number on a fake and gets out to midfield. That will set up this Chris Negron 1-yard run, and we're tied at 7. Judinski will score on his second touchdown run of the day to put the Eagles back in front before Mike Hayes calls his own number and finds pay dirt to pull the Greyhounds to within 1 at 14-13. After the teams exchange touchdowns, Judinski is intercepted by Chris McGrath in the fourth quarter. That will set up this Mike Hayes to Jalen Snyder-Scipio touchdown pass to put the Hounds up 27-21. Juniata had two last chances in the fourth quarter, but Judinski is picked off here by Jimmy McCarthy. And then he's picked off by Chris McGrath. Moravian moves to 5-4 with a 27-21 victory. Susquehanna went across the Mason-Dixon line to take on McDaniel. Trailing 3-0, Tyad Campbell runs 25 yards deep into Crusader territory. That's going to set up this Matty Callahan to Nick Amelia touchdown pass to give the Green Terror a 7-3 lead. Then a halfback option from Ian Richardson to Quani Hale makes it a 10-7 Susquehanna lead. McDaniel came right back. Amelia in a 35-yard touchdown pass would set up this Spencer Wiersberg field goal. We're tied at 10 at the break. Amelia had a big day here, pulling up this 47-yard catch to set up a Tyad Campbell touchdown, make it 16-10. Nick Krusko throws to Pat Murtha, 2-yard touchdown pass to make it 17-16 Susquehanna. After a missed McDaniel field goal, Murtha takes this little swing pass and goes 33 yards, setting up Ian Richardson. This 10-yard run to give Susquehanna a 24-16 lead. McDaniel had one last chance here. Olivetto, 15 yards to the 10-yard line. But Callahan's pass is picked off by Susquehanna. The Crusaders going to win 24-16.